Good morning, everyone. Hope all are fine, well, by the grace of Almighty God. Stay at home and stay safe. Let us begin with the first chapter of the history, the Harappan civilization. What is civilization? Civilization is said to be an advanced stage of the human cultural development, which implies the use of superior technology and complex economic relationships. Some of the traits which mark a civilization are evolution of cities, surplus food, division of labor, system of writing, public buildings, development of technology. The period between 4000 and 3000 BC saw remarkable progress. Man acquired greater knowledge and skill in mastering the forces of nature. He took to agriculture and made more efficient tools and started living a settled life on the banks of rivers. So a number of dispersed farming villages evolved first into towns and then into cities. The river valleys had the agriculture potential to support a dense population and produce surplus food. The surplus food freed some people from the task of producing their own food. These individuals gradually became specialists and developed a substantial range of new skills such as writing, using metals and making their alloys, seal making and large-scale construction. Such knowledge and skills enabled people to advance a new stage in the progress of civilization. The Harappan civilization. The discovery of Indus Valley civilization in the 20th century was an important event in the history of India. Up to this time, it was believed that the history of India began with the advent of Aryans. However, the discovery of the Harappan civilization stretched back the origin of the Indian history so as to put it as par with the other oldest civilization of the world, namely Mesopotamian and Egyptian civilization. The Indus Valley civilization is best known as the Harappan culture or the Harappan civilization. The term culture is used by the archaeologists for a group of objects, the distinctive in style, that are usually found together with a specific geographical area and period of time. In the case of Harappan culture, these distinctive objects are seals, weights, stone blades and baked bricks. It is also called the Harappan civilization because in the year 1921, at the modern site of Harappa, situated in the province of West Punjab in Pakistan, Mohenjo-daro was discovered in 1922. Both the sites lie in the Indus Valley region. Sources. Our knowledge of the Harappan civilization is based entirely on the archaeological remains such as buildings, pottery, sculpture, seals and cemeteries. This is so because no adequate written records are available. A number of seals were discovered with a few letters engraved on each, but the script has not been deciphered as yet. Therefore, the major sources of our information about the Harappan civilization are the following. The Great Bath, the Citadel, Seals, Bearded Man, Dancing Girl, Dockyard, and Script. Let us know about the Great Bath. The Great Bath is one of the largest public buildings at Mohenjo-daro. It has a large rectangular tank in the courtyard surrounded by a corridor on all four sides. There are two flights of steps, one in the north and the other one in the south, leading into the tank. To make the pool watertight, burnt bricks and mortar lined with bitumen and gypsum were used for construction. The water for the bath was provided by a well in an adjacent room. Surrounding the bath were the porticos and set of rooms and a stairway which led to an upper story. Some scholars believe that these rooms were provided for the members of some kind of priesthood, whereas others think that the rooms were provided for changing clothes. This structure with several distinctive features has led scholars to suggest that it was meant for some kind of a ritual bath. The Great Bath is an important source of information that throws light on the life of the people and culture of the Harappan civilization. Summary: the construction of the Great Bath indicates that the art of building had reached a high degree of perfection at that time. The massive structure points out that there might have existed a ruling class that could mobilize labor, collect taxes, and build such a huge structure for the public. Most of the scholars agree that the Great Bath might have been used for religious purposes. This indicates the importance attached to ceremonial bathing in the sacred tanks, pools, and rivers since time immemorial. The design of the Great Bath portrays the efficient planning in the structural features relating to water supply and sewage disposal. The citadel. The raised area of an each city was called the citadel. It owed its height to the buildings constructed on mud brick platforms. The citadel had the houses of the ruling class and important buildings like the Great Bath, the granary, and the assembly hall and the workshops. It points to the elaborate planning that went into the development of cities and justifies that the Harappan civilization was an urban civilization. The presence of specific buildings and houses of the ruling class indicates some sort of social classification. Seals. The seals used by the Harappans show their artistic skills. About 2,000 seals have been discovered. Of these, a great majority comprise short inscriptions with pictures of one horned bull, buffalo, tiger, goat, elephant, and rhinoceros. Material used in making the seals comprise terracotta, statite, agate, etc. Most of the seals are rectangular or square, but some of them are circular in shape. Harappan seals provide useful information about the script, trade, religion, and beliefs of the Harappans. Seals of Pashupati show that people believed in Shiva. Bearded man. The stone sculpture of a man with a beard was discovered from Mohenjo-daro. The statue had a shawl worn over the left shoulder and the eyes are half closed. Therefore, some scholars believe that this is the statue of a yogi. This sculpture is of high artistic value and points to the existence of skilled artisans in the Harappan civilization. Dancing girl. The bronze statue of a dancing girl found at Mohenjo-daro is a masterpiece of art and it shows a high degree of development in the art of sculpture. The figurine shows vigor, variety, and ingenuity. The right arm of a dancing girl rests on the hip and the left arm is heavily bangled. It holds a small bowl against her left leg. Dockyard. A rectangular dockyard was discovered at Lothal in Gujarat. It was surrounded by a massive brick wall, probably as a protection against floods. The dockyard made of baked bricks was connected by channels to the Gulf of Cambay. Lothal was an important trading and manufacturing center of the Indus Valley civilization and was used for carrying out overseas trade. Script. The Harappans used a script which is regarded as pictographic since its signs represent birds, fish, and varieties of the human form. The number of signs of Harappan script is known to be between 375 and 400. The script is found inscribed on a number of seals, copper tools, rims of jar, copper and terracotta tablets, jewelry, and on an ancient signboard. There are several theories about the origin of the Harappan civilization. These can be categorized into two groups. First one is foreign origin and the second one is indigenous origin. Foreign origin. Some scholars believe that the civilization came into existence as a result of a sudden migration of people with an urban civilization to the Indus Basin. According to these scholars, the Harappan civilization was an offshoot of the Mesopotamian civilization. However, excavations at various Harappan sites have indicated striking differences between the Harappan and the Mesopotamian civilization. The recent researchers show that the roots of the Harappan civilization lie deep in the Indian soil. According to some historians, the urban Harappan culture was only an outgrowth of the extensive local village cultures and not of foreign origin. These cultures probably contributed to the growth of the Harappan civilization together with the external stimulus provided by the trade, with the external stimulus provided by the trade contacts with Mesopotamia. There are several theories about the origin of Harappan civilization. These can be categorized into two groups: foreign origin, indigenous origin. Some scholars believe that the civilization came into existence as a result of a modern migration of people with an urban civilization to the Indus Basin. According to these scholars, the Harappan civilization was an offshoot of the Mesopotamian civilization. However, excavations at various Harappan sites have indicated striking differences between the Harappan and the Mesopotamian civilization. The recent researchers show that the roots of the Harappan civilization lie deep in the Indian soil. According to some historians, the urban Harappan culture was only an outgrowth of the extensive local village cultures and not of foreign origin. This cultures probably contributed to the growth of the Harappan civilization together with the external stimulus provided by trade contacts with Mesopotamia. Extent of the civilization. The entire area of the Harappan civilization is triangular in shape and accounts for about 1.3 million square kilometers and was the largest area amongst the ancient civilization. It extended from Suttagender on the seacoast of South Balochistan in the west to Alamgirpur in the upper Ganga Yamuna Doab in western UP in the east, and from Manda in Jammu in the north to Bhagat Rao in Narbada estuary in the south. The largest sites of the Harappan civilization, however, are Mohenjo-daro, Harappa, Kalibangan and Lothal. Urban planning. Harappan cities. The two most important Harappan cities are Harappa in Montgomery district of Punjab and Mohenjo-daro in Larkana district of Sindh, now both in Pakistan. These two cities are linked by the river Indus, and hence the name of the civilization is the Indus Valley Civilization. A third city lies at Chandan-daro, about 130 kilometers south of Mohenjo-daro. The fourth city is at Lothal in Gujarat, at the head of the Gulf of Cambay. The fifth city lies at Kalibangan, northern Rajasthan, and the sixth, called Banawali, is situated in Hisar district in Haryana. The features of urban planning was as follows. Each city was divided into two parts, the raised area called the citadel and the lower town. The citadel owed its height to the buildings which were constructed on mud brick platforms. The main streets followed a grid pattern running from north to south or from east to west. The houses at street corners were rounded to allow carts to pass easily. House drains emptied all wastewater into the street drains. The streets crossed the main road at right angles, dividing the city into square or rectangular blocks. Houses. The main characteristics of houses were the following. The residential buildings were built according to a set plan on a high mound in order to protect them from floods. Their foundations were very deep.